friends, again I am here with new year. First of all, happy new year all of you. Now you know the things which is coming, the seasonal end. So in this one we will discuss the annual portion of our syllabus. After that, we will prepare for the examination. So you know, EET having some chapters for half yearly and some for annual. So regarding this, in class 7, we will discuss about the chapters. Class 6, we will discuss about chapter 9 now, today. It is the disposal of garbage. So how we dispose garbage and how it is, if not disposed, then it is very much affected to us, affect our health, our environment, our surroundings. So see, in this regard, class EET for class 6, chapter 9, having disposal of garbage, how we dispose the garbage. And in safe way. So disposal is very easy word, but how we dispose in safe way, this is the main thing. So in this one, we will dispose the garbage of solid, liquid or gaseous type. And say, the types of garbage may be either solid, in the form of solid, in the form of liquid or gaseous form. You see, garbage means what? Garbage means rubbish or waste, especially refuse of domestic, okay, refuse, especially domestic refuse, this is domestic refuse, it means they mainly come from the domestic area, so this is not useful to us at all, so we should dispose them in safe way, safe manner. So first, solid waste. You see, solid waste or garbage. So solid garbage, you know, which is heaped. If we collect them in a place, it become heaped. So you see the heap of garbage near the market complex or the area where there is rush or where there is more population. So they throw their waste outside. And municipality pick them and dispose them in safe way. So if the system is properly run or good, then after there is nothing problematic. If the system is not properly working, then the things become not in our control. So it is necessary to dispose them in proper way. Now see how we dispose them. So solid garbage, understood? The solid things as a garbage, as a waste substance which is produced from our surrounding area, from the civil area, from the market area, from different areas where there is generated. So we can dispose that properly. How we dispose? So for solid waste disposal or garbage disposal, we have auxiliary operations or principal operations. So auxiliary operations is what? The operation which includes the physical separation or removal, dumping or pulverization or the compaction and baling. So this is the way by which safely the garbage dispose. The second one, principal operations, that is compositing, composting, stationary landfilling, thermal process, recycling and reuse. Another way, principal ways by which we can minimize the garbage or their bad effect on human beings or our society or our environment. So say one by one we will discuss about these things. So physical removal, you know, rat pickers comes to our locality and they can pick the bottles, they can pick the glass pieces, they can pick the iron pieces or different type of things. They pick and they use them or they sold them to the collection of unwanted substances which is found here and there. They collected them and they disposed them to the kabadiwala. Here the intermediate is kabadiwala. They can either recycle, either so physical surface removal means what? They can remove the substances which are biodegradable, which are non-biodegradable, and then they can use them in different ways. So if they are recyclable, they can recycle them. If they are non-recyclable, they can biodegrade, means they can make them another useful substances from them. Now dumping, the lowland area become dump, or the garbage or the waste which is present in the lowland area, means here and there, they can collect the garbage and dump in the area. Dumping is done in safe way if the dump is again covered by a thin layer of soil. If you dump any waste which are toxic, which are different, means non-biodegradable, then you should cover them, a thin layer of soil on them, so it will not allow any stray animal or insects to let their breeding ground, and they are able to do the activity which increase their numbers. So this is the dumping, which should be in safe way, and its bad impact should not be go to the underground water. So we should be careful regarding the dumping. Pulverization means what? Pulverization means the process by which the activity of solid waste grinding, means they are grinded and smashed by a special machine to convert it into pieces. So say small pieces. So they can grind it. The garbage grinded, and after that its amount become reduced. This reduced amount is easy to dispose. So this is the pulverization by which their amount should be reduced by grinding. Compaction and baling. Nowadays compaction takes place. So the small trucks, they can collect the garbage from the different municipality areas, and after that a big truck is there which have compaction machine. They can receive the garbage from the small trolleys or trucks, and after that they compact, they make them compact, compress them and making them smaller volume. And then baling, baling means they can make their layers and they dispose them in a safe place. So this is the compaction and baling and then disposal. So these are the auxiliary operations by which we can operate them in these four ways. Now the principal operation of solid waste, how we operate the solid waste in principal ways. Yeah, composting. You see, which is the garbage which is biodegradable and having organic in nature, we can put them in compost feed for composting process. Composting is the process by which we can make the bio fertilizer, and it is very useful for our farmers and for our crop feeds. So this is the composting by which we can make the compost of degradable substances present in the garbage. Now stationary landfilling. So see, in this process, stationary landfilling, the process is done by the help of process, the solid waste are scientifically filled to the lowland areas. This is just like dumping, but in which scientific methods are applied, and this process of filling of waste in lowland is done in a such a way that waste cannot create any type of hazardous to public health. Means it should be done scientifically to hazardous for the locality or for the local area people. So in scientific way they can dispose in the land. Now thermal process. Really thermal process means burning solid waste under high controlled conditions is called the thermal process. But really this process is not prescribed, because it can consume more amount of energy, as well as it is a process in which the things are not good, because they emit carbon dioxide, also the toxic gases they emitted. So thermal process, in energy consuming as well as that is a polluting the nature. That's why it is not very much prescribed by the persons, or it is not very supportive to our nature. Now the last one is recycling and reuse. See, this is very easy to know that recycling and reuse protect the resources. It means if you want to consume more and more resources, you have to recycle them. Otherwise, new resources, when you take, it will lessen, it will over after some time. So their amount is also less. And if you want to protect or conserve the amount of the resources, we have to recycle or reuse the resource which is going on or which is circulating in our nature. Now say, these are the solid waste, their disposal. Now liquid waste. So these are liquid waste, our garbage. How you understood that sewage water, drain water, having the waste or having some chemicals in it. Waste like some pesticides, detergents, leaches, dyes, etc. These all are creating the liquid waste, liquid garbage generation. And if it is present in our water, and finally it leads to the water bodies, natural water bodies, and then harm our nature. So this is the activities in which harming of the nature is not a proper thing. So liquid waste should be them as soon as possible. The things become normal. So say, what method is utilized, or we can use what method we can use for disposal of the gaseous waste. So first one, combustion. In this process, the chemical form of gaseous pollutants are charged by heating them with certain chemicals. So we can charge them with some chemicals. Thus, less harmful substances are produced, and that do not cause harmful effects when mixed with the air. So say, first one, combustion. So with the help of chemical, we can make them less effective, less harmful. Absorption. In this process, the polluted air is passed through containers filled with the specific absorbent. So see, second one, absorption. Absorption is the process. Absorption. In this one, we can do the activity. One thing means we can pass the substance, means air which are polluted, with the help of which thing? Some absorbent. So this is the way absorb means harmful substances, harmful things can absorb. And third one, and the pure air will be released. Third one, adsorption. In this process, adsorption. In this process, the polluted air is passed through special chambers containing the chemical absorbent. Okay, those chemicals absorbents adsorb chemical found in the polluted air. It means in this one, the air, polluted air can pass through adsorbent. Or over the garment disposal, and if we think these things positive to our nature. Okay, thank you.